Hello, Los Al, and welcome to the first episode.
I'm Zach.
And I'm Nikki. A ton of things have changed since students first returned to campus.
Hey there, kids. I'm Mrs. Vienna, and I just want to go over some of the new changes that are happening as you guys roll back on campus. So first of all, we have this really cool QR code all over campus. And what it is, it's a map for all of you that have not been on campus in a year and a half, or are brand new to our campus. If you don't know where you're at and you see that little QR code, go ahead and put your phone and there you go. You'll have a full map of the school and be able to navigate where all your classes are. Second, we have this wonderful thing that we are doing with masks. Indoors, we want to make sure that all students have their masks on at all times. That means they are covering your nose, your chin, and they are fully on the entire time the minute you step into the class or are in the hallways that are closed in. Once you get outside at lunch and passing period, it is up to you if you want to wear your mask or not. And then finally, we have this awesome sanitizer. It is everywhere on campus. Please use it. It keeps us safe, keeps us COVID-free, and it really helps protect everyone. Have a great year. Come see us if you have any questions. Bye.
Did you hear about all the events coming up?
Yeah, of course I have. Yeah, I'm not dumb.
Well, that's questionable.
Questionable.
Weekly update with Emily Fitzgerald.
Emily, are you cool with that?
She left.
I'm Emily Fitzgerald. Here's the latest. College Day is being held on Wednesday, September 1st. Keep your eyes peeled because it's approaching faster than you can say, crushing student debt. The Harry Potter-themed fall play, titled Puffs, is holding auditions on Thursday, September 9th. It was originally titled Slithers, until the drama department decided there weren't enough girls with Slytherin in their bio willing to participate. More information can be found at losaldrama.org. Wednesday, September 1st, marks Parent Guardian Event Back to School Night, in which parents attend each of their child's classes and are forced to learn the entire curriculum in a single night. They will be tested, so parents, bring a pencil. If you fail, who knows what'll happen to you? I have just been informed that Back to School Night is not, in fact, what I thought it was. It is an informational night for parents.
Did you know that Vogue came to our school?
You mean Vogue?
Yeah, the article thing place. Maybe.
Hello, welcome. Come on in. During my free time, my favorite thing to do is garden. I have a very large garden where I grow a lot of fruits and vegetables and herbs in my backyard. Actually, my favorite place on campus is outside with the students. That is my absolute favorite place, and especially in the mornings when I get to greet students and welcome them to school every day. I think I'm reflective. Open and kind. And I don't know if I'm very talented at it anymore, but I was a pretty good softball player, and I was a college coach. My most favorite thing is being part of all the different activities and programs that the students are doing and to support them in that. Adios.
Zach, what device did you bring to school?
8-bit. MOS Technology 6502 Apple computer.
What?
It's from the 80s.
How would you even carry that around?
BYOD allows students to bring and use their own technology during the day to enhance the learning experience. One of Los Al's goals is to ensure that through BYOD, each student's interaction with technology contributes positively to the learning environment. If you can, make sure you bring your own device to school.
What up, Big In? You struggling? You need a help of a good luck pal?
What would you know anyway? You're just a good luck pal.
Us good luck pals get a bad rap. Actually, I'm the only good luck pal. I'm one of a kind.
I don't know.
I'm a good luck pal. Everyone hates me, but I'm still a good luck pal.
Yeah, okay.
It's a recessive gene. I can't help it. Both my parents are normal size.
That sneaky recessive gene, man. I mean,
it's not like I chose to be a good luck pal.
Your parents are human, you're just a good luck pal trying to do his best, you know? I get that. That's how it gets you. You know what? This has really opened my eyes.
Take this. It's a pen. Just draw on your face when you forget your notes. Just believe in the power of a good luck pal, okay?
Bye now.
Oh, okay.
Goodbye.
Ian, I'm your teacher. Tomorrow morning, when you get in class, I need you to turn in your Latin roots. There's only 24 of them. It's gonna be pretty easy. Just, what are you doing with that marker?
I don't write down homework.
Just write it down.
No, there's nothing to worry about. No, this good luck pal gave me this marker to draw on my face with.
Okay.
It's gonna help me remember my homework when I look in the mirror later. Who drew on my face? Oh, that's right, I have 24 group Latin words to recognize. Okay.
Now let's read some tweets.
We don't have Twitter.
And DMs. Kaleidoscope says, let me on the mic. No.
Tori Peterson, BTS says, what's your favorite sauce from McDonald's? Or do y'all eat your nuggets dry? Personally, I think honey mustard's the best. Any other sauce is heresy.
Tyler J underscore 2527 says, when are we getting the new logo? Right now.
Thank you for watching Griffin News Episode 1.
Make sure to follow us on Instagram at Griffin News 2022.
Stay classy, Losau.
And teachers, back to you.